Okay, let's see. If economic globalization is inevitable, it should primarily serve humanity rather than the interests of transnational corporations. Yeah, big agree. I'd always support my country, whether it's right or wrong. Yep. No one chooses his or her country of birth, so it's foolish to be proud of it. Disagree. I'm proud of my country. I'm proud of who I am. Proud of my heritage. Our race has many superior qualities. Well, you know, if I answer agree, people are going to call me a white supremacist, but I don't know. I feel like every race has attributes that are exceptional. So I'm already stumped. I got to be optical. I agree. I'm not a white supremacist. I don't think we're the best or better than other people, but we have some exceptional attributes, clearly. 16 years I've been popping these pills. The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Disagree. Military action that defies international law is justified. Absolutely. International law is gay. I don't believe in it. I've never really believed in international law. There's no such thing. It only matters when it's enforceable, and international law is hardly enforceable. So, there is now a worrying fusion of information and entertainment. Yeah, I agree with that on some level. You look at, like, Taylor Swift telling people to vote in Tennessee. Like, that's no good. And also, a lot of Hollywood stuff. You know, I'm sure maybe they're thinking about Fox News when they write this question. Or InfoWars, but I think about Hollywood and I think about celebrities. So, people are ultimately divided more by class than by nationality. Yeah, big disagree. Divided by race. Controlling inflation is more important than controlling unemployment. Yeah, monetary policy is critical. If you don't get the monetary policy right, the economy collapses. Economy can do well with, you know, relatively high unemployment. But if inflation is too high, then the whole society falls apart. So that is true. Because corporations cannot be trusted to voluntarily protect the environment, they require regulation. Yep. Yeah, we know that's true. From each according to his ability, to each according to his need, is a fundamentally good idea. No, I disagree. I disagree because you have people that have, you know, it is true that people are going to have different talents. People are going to work, you know, some will work harder than others, and so some should have more. I don't believe in total equality. I believe in inequality. It's a sad reflection on our society that something as basic as drinking water is now a bottled consumer product. No. Yeah, I agree with Ben on that. Why? Yeah, why would that be a bad thing? A lot of left-wing people look at that cynically, but, I mean, water is a commodity. It's scarce. Particularly something like bottled water is scarce, and so it should be managed through the price system. I don't know why they say that like that's something horrible. It's cheap. Land should not be a commodity to be bought and sold. Disagree. Yeah, what else would you do with it? What else would you do with it other than buy and sell it? Would the government control it? Let's see. Otherwise, the government owns all the land, and what, they just give it away? I mean, how is that any better than buying and selling? I mean, don't get me wrong, there should be public lands, and there should be lands that are protected from private property. You know, some lands should be owned by the people collectively. But, you know, like public parks and wildlife preserves and things like that. But yeah, broadly speaking, I believe that that's good for economic development. I'm not a Marxist, okay? I'm not a leftist on economics. It is regrettable that many personal fortunes are made by people who simply manipulate money and contribute nothing to their society. You know, again, with that one, you know, I was memeing on Ben when he answered that question. But it is true that there are people in the stock market that do serve a role. You know, risk assessment and a lot of that, it is important in a financial complex economy that we have. So, although that being said, though, there are people that become ludicrously wealthy because they manage money like this. The real money manipulators are the bankers. That's the real problem. And a lot of the bankers are corrupt. So I'm going to say slightly agree. Well, I'm kind of in the middle on that. Because, you know, again, you see, look at somebody like Warren Buffett, and you could say that he simply manipulates money, but I mean, he makes a lot of money for a lot of people, you know, if they invest in his fund, his hedge fund. And that is directing investment capital and things like that. So, I don't know. I'm going to say disagree. That's a skill set. Protectionism is sometimes necessary in trade. Strongly agree. Always necessary. We must protect our industry. The only social responsibility of a company should be to deliver a profit. Disagree. You have social responsibility to your country. And you have a social responsibility to God and to the people. So I disagree in a big way. The rich are too highly taxed. They are not too highly taxed. They might have a higher tax rate, but they don't pay it. What is the effective tax rate of the rich? It's often much lower than our tax rate. And they might provide more of the tax revenue because of the way math works. If you tax a billionaire at 10%, it's going to be more money than if you tax a middle-class person at 25%, right? In terms of the total amount of money. But we know that effective tax rates for the rich are lower. The tax rate on capital gains is 15% after 365 days. And if you can afford certain accounts and lawyers, then you can get out of paying a lot. So I disagree. They pay a lot, and they pay more than us in gross terms, but in terms of a proportion, they get out of a lot. So I'm going to say disagree. Those with the ability to pay should have access to higher standards of medical care. Yeah, why would that not be the case? We should strive to make it such that everybody should have a high standard of medical care, but obviously, if you look at like elective surgeries or cosmetic type things or things that are unnecessary, you know, healthcare resources are scarce like any other resource. And not everybody can have every procedure and everything that needs to be done. Everybody should have a minimum level of good healthcare like we have in the United States. But if you have more money, why should you not be able to afford more things? You know, people don't like to talk like that. You can't put a price tag on health or life. Well, actually, you kind of can in some ways. You can put a price tag on healthcare resources, which have to be economized. It has to be economized. Governments should penalize businesses that mislead the public. Absolutely. A genuine free market requires restrictions on the ability of predator multinationals to create monopolies. Yeah. I hear all these libertarians talking about these so-called natural monopolies that are impossible. The only real monopolies are created by government. I don't think that's true, actually. Maybe you don't have total monopolies, but you certainly have close to it. Oligopolies. And historically, there have been monopolies that have been natural if they're based on certain resources or certain technology. So, I mean, I agree in some sense with that, but not completely. And yeah, there are predator multinationals. This is more talking actually about developing countries, actually. I think that's the gist of this question. It's talking about the IMF, the World Bank, and multinational corporations that will come into small developing countries, and they basically do create like indentured servitude. They'll give huge loans, which they'll never be able to pay back. Multinationals come in and dominate the economy, and you know, that's not good. The freer the market, the freer the people. You know, I mean, this is certainly true to an extent. To an extent, this is true, but what does freedom mean? Freedom from sin? No. Freedom from, you know, certain things? No. So I'm going to say in the things that matter, that's not always true. Jake is in chat. Jake Lloyd? Let me make him a moderator. Jake Lloyd, welcome. Jaden, Jake Lloyd in chat. Great to see you guys. Any other e-celebs hanging out? Any other important e-celebs? Abortion, when the woman's life is not threatened, should always be illegal, of course. All authority should be questioned, not God's authority. I mean, I agree with this in some sense. I agree with questioning the government or questioning the establishment, or, you know, it's good to question even God. You know, you read the Bible, and in the Bible you have questioning. It's okay to question and investigate, but to a certain extent, you must accept. I mean, Demestra writes about this. Demestra, the illiberal, anti-Enlightenment philosopher, writes about how the fatal flaw of constitutionalism is too much skepticism. Any constitution can be totally undermined by skeptics. The only constitution that is solvent is one that is based on God, because you cannot question God's authority. So not all authority, that's the operative word. Most authority, and in most cases, but ultimately there's a limiting principle. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Big agree. Is that biblical? I think Jesus said not to do that, right? Didn't Jesus say not to do that? Let me look that up. I don't know, man. I don't know. Pretty sure Jesus said that's not okay, but I kind of think that sometimes. Jesus said that's a no-no. Okay, then we put disagree. I'm down with whatever Jesus says. I don't know. I'm, you know, maybe I'm just a little too vengeful. That's my problem. Taxpayers should not be expected to prop up any theaters or museums that cannot survive on a commercial basis. Disagree. There is a social value to theaters and museums, even if they're not profitable. And there's value to things that are not profitable. Schools should not make classroom attendance compulsory. Disagree. You should be in school. It's just that, you know, you got to be going to school. And so my ideal vision is that, you know, you're going to have schools, but they're going to be like religious schools, you know, and they'll be teaching like love for the state, well, love for the country and love for God and things like that. So I think kids should be in school. All people have their rights, but it is better for all of us that different sorts of people should keep to their own kind. Yes. Yeah, it is. Everyone should keep to their own kind. Like should be with like. Good parents sometimes have to spank their children. I don't agree with that. It's natural for children to keep secrets from their parents. Yeah, I agree with Ben on that one. It's natural, but it's not wise. Possessing marijuana for personal use should not be a criminal offense. Disagree. You're a criminal for, you know, purchasing marijuana and for having it. The prime function of schooling should be to equip the future generation to find jobs. I think the function of schooling should be moral and patriotic education. And also liberal arts is important. I think, you know, what we're doing with our schools, this perfunctory training towards college or towards jobs. I mean, we want schools to be practical, but we also want to create public virtue in our schools. The state can promote that. I think the primary purpose of schooling, even today, is not for that reason. It's daycare now and getting like kids off the streets. But what it should be there to do is to promote public virtue, particularly in men. People with serious inheritable disability should not be allowed to reproduce. I don't think that's Christian, so I'm going to say disagree. Most important thing for children to learn is to accept discipline. I don't know if I agree with that. What is this? I've never heard this track. We got love, I guess we'll just skip ahead here. Yeah, no, the most important thing for children to learn to accept is Jesus. There are no savage and civilized peoples. There are only different cultures.
That's not true.
But that's not true. There are civilized peoples and savage peoples, and we all know that. So I disagree. Those who are able to work and refuse the opportunity should not expect society support. Yeah, big agree. When you are troubled, it's better not to think about it, but to keep busy with more cheerful things. Disagree. We should dwell. We should dwell on dark things sometimes. You have to think about it. First, Ben Shapiro said he agreed with that. No. We are suffering from too much optimism. We have to dwell on mortality. First generation immigrants can never be fully integrated with their new country. Yeah, that's basically true. What's good for the most successful corporations is always ultimately good for all of us. No. With this one, it's like, to be a first-generation immigrant, you don't speak the language, you don't know the culture. If you're an immigrant, I mean, you're probably an adult already. What does assimilation mean? You're not assimilated. You can't be. No broadcasting institution, however independent its content, should receive public funding. I think there should be, like, state media. But because all media is terrible, I'm going to say disagree. I'm going to say disagree because we don't want the government funding liberal media. Our civil liberties are being excessively curbed in the name of counterterrorism. I do agree with that. The way to stop terrorism is to close the borders, not surveillance. A significant advantage of a one-party state is that it avoids all the arguments to delay progress in a democratic political system. That is an advantage, yeah. I mean, I'm not in favor of a one-party state, but that is an advantage. I mean, the counter argument is that those arguments are productive, that those arguments are shaping policy, and because there's competition, then that means it's always about competition, a market. We have to have a market for everything, a market for dating, a market for politics, a market for this. So, I mean, I'm not in favor of a one-party state, but you do get to act more swiftly. Look at China. Look at how quickly China was able to do their quarantine and control what happened with coronavirus. Although the electronic age makes official surveillance easier, only wrongdoers need to be worried. Yeah, what about dissidents? The death penalty should be an option for the most serious crimes. Big agree. If you're like a terrorist. In a civilized society, one must always have people above to be obeyed and people below to be commanded. I mean, a civilized society is hierarchical, but I don't know if I love this idea of like, oh, well, some people are commanding and some people are commanded. I mean, it is true that hierarchy is good, but it doesn't have to be a strict and explicit hierarchy of, we're not talking about a military state. I'm not in favor of like turning the whole country into the military or a caste system. I'm talking about simply the hierarchy of, you know, largely through merit, but also through sacrifice, class in some ways, gender. So I'm in favor of a soft hierarchy. I don't like this, you know, civilized society as people being told what to do. I don't want to be told what to do. Maybe because I want to tell other people what to do. So I slightly disagree with this. Abstract art that doesn't represent anything shouldn't be considered art at all. Well, you have to think about what abstract art is. You know, there is abstract, like, modern art that is garbage, but there's abstract art that can be good, frankly. So, I don't know, I'm kind of on the fence with that one. Some modern art, frankly, is good. Some modern art to me is reflective or descriptive of the time, and it has value, and it is art. So I think abstract art can be art. Maybe it's not good art, but it's art. In criminal justice, punishment should be more important than rehabilitation. Yeah, gotta deter. The problem with crime is people. There's a population of criminals amongst us in every generation. Something like 10% of the population is criminals. Criminals, people that just can't get along, and they just have to be put in jail. They just have to be, you know, put in jail and controlled. And I'm not talking about any particular racial group. I'm talking about in any country in any time, you've got a percentage of the population that will be dysfunctional. And maybe that population changes over time, or it's different parts of the population, but every demographic has a percentage that is just can't get along, and those people cannot be rehabilitated. They just have to be locked away or deterred, or, you know, whatever. Stop saying please, can we watch the optics? Watch our optics, please. Yeah, please, can we get an optics check? Do not get me banned. It is a waste of time to try to rehabilitate criminals. Yeah, some criminals definitely agree. Some of these people are animals, man. You look at some of these criminals in the cities and they're animals. Look at these drug cartels in Mexico. Those people are, talk about savages. You should see what these drug cartels do in Mexico. My friend Millennial Matt, this guy's like a, you know, he's in the dark underground of the internet. He was telling me about a video that he watched of a cartel person cutting off a guy's eyelids and making him eat his fingers. Like, people like that just have to be locked away or killed. The business person and the manufacturer are more important than the writer and the artist. I disagree. Important is subjective. Important for what? I mean, ultimately, the artist and the writer give meaning to our existence. You know, the Bible was written. And the Sistine Chapel was created by an artist. You know, think about that. So a lot of the things that are sublime are created by creatives. You would think that I'm maybe like an Alex P. Keaton type that like loves the industry. And I do love industry. But art and literature are important. And maybe even more important than goods. Mothers may have careers, but their first duty is to be homemakers. Yeah, we know that. Multinational companies are unethically exploiting. Somebody says workers built it. Yeah, because artists designed it. Workers could not make things. Workers are told to make things, okay? Manufacturers, I mean, certainly there is a reciprocal relationship, but let's not forget which begot which. You know, it's like when a lot of these Democrats say that blacks built the United States. Well, not quite. Blacks built the White House. Yeah, well, who, like, designed the White House? There was an architect, right? I mean, maybe they laid the bricks, but it's not hard to lay bricks. One is definitely more inaccessible than the other. Okay, looks like Yandi is over, so let me put on some other music, I guess. Why don't we listen to, let's listen to GQ. This is a good song. This is a good mellow song. I'm just going to put my Spotify on shuffle. I'll just see what comes up. Tell me if we're still good on volume, by the way, or if it's louder or quieter, just so I know. Multinational companies. We got Jaden in chat here. Okay, Jaden's texting me. I'll look at that in a minute. Multinational companies are unethically exploiting the plant genetic resources of developing countries. Plant genetic resources. What does that mean? Is that GMOs? Or is that like, what, fruit, vegetables? I don't know enough about that question. I would say, I don't know if it's unethical because they would not be exploiting their own resources. Largely multinational corporations, they do prey on American markets, but largely it's European, Asian, and North American firms necessarily preying on the third world. And I say necessarily because if we didn't harness their resources, they would not. You know, it's like a new form of colonialism, and there's kind of nothing wrong with that. Like, think about Africa before, the Berlin Conference. Think about Africa before the, what is it called? The Scramble for Africa. Think about before the 19th century colonization of Africa. Were they exporting a lot of gold and diamonds and, rare earth minerals? No. Because they had spears and didn't have the wheel. And we came in and we took over, and it was a very hard form of economic and political control. And we left, and we could watch Audio Africa and show you what happened when we left in the 60s and 70s, but it wasn't good. So the American firms do have to go in there and take their resources. And if they get a little cut of it, then that's great for everybody. But otherwise, we wouldn't get their resources, and we need the resources. We need their resources, and they're not going to sell them to us because they're too busy fighting and stabbing and shooting each other over ancient tribal differences and like voodoo magic and things like that. So we have to take their stuff, and we can give them a cut, and they can do with that what they want. But being paternalistic towards these lesser civilizations is, to me, makes sense. I said bitty instead of busy. Shut up. Making peace with the establishment is an important aspect of maturity. Yeah, I mean, on some level. Like, I will never make peace with the GOP establishment, but I've made peace with the way things are. If you're talking about making peace with, like, society, I mean, what does the establishment mean? That's way too vague. Because in as far as, like, the political establishment goes, no, there will never be peace. But as far as the establishment, meaning the traditional mode of living, you know, we have to drop fantastical ideas and delusion. So I would say I generally agree with that. That's my big problem with a lot of young people that watch my show or hate me even. People that don't like my show is they're too fanciful or idealistic. And it's okay to be idealistic, but you have to be practical. You have to have ideals. It's different to have ideals than to be idealistic. You have to be practical. And you could have ideals while being practical. That's what I do. I'm practical. But I'm not somebody that's under any illusions about what is possible. Astrology accurately explains many things. Big disagree. You cannot be moral without being religious. Yep. And the problem with this question is a lot of people conflate moral with, like, what is traditionally perceived to be moral. Can non-religious people do things that are considered moral traditionally or according to the mainstream religion? Yes. You can be not religious and be celibate, for example, or you could be not religious and refrain from stealing. But fundamentally, there is no morality without religion. Morality is a word without meaning. So, quite literally, you cannot be moral. You cannot be a moral actor if you're not religious, because only through something transcendent, only through belief in something spiritual or religious, do you have any kind of objective moral belief, right and wrong. Without a spiritual understanding or a spiritual orientation, all we are is matter. And there, how can you color a purely material world with something like right and wrong? In other words, if all I am is a collection of atoms, what does right and wrong mean? What does good and bad mean? It means nothing. What is good and evil? I'm a collection of atoms. You're a collection of atoms. Everything is atoms, just arranged and smashing into each other and rearranging itself. It's just matter ceaselessly rearranging itself. And there is no such thing. Morality for a materialist is a social construct. It is something that we have constructed. It is therefore not objectively real. So you cannot be and it's not like you can't be a good person, but what does good mean? You don't know. You have to have a religious tradition or a, you know, religious frame of reference in order to determine what is good. So maybe you could do things that are moral, right? But you have to have religious people for you to do something moral, to perceive it, to witness it, to establish a basis for that. So no, you cannot be moral. And a lot of people mix those things up. They're like, you're saying that I can't be a good person if I'm not religious? No, you could live according to Christ's commandments if you're not religious, but in your world, you understand what I'm saying? You need religious people to say that you're a good person. Otherwise, you're just a person doing things which are random and chaotic and meaningless. Let's see. Charity is better than Social Security as a means of helping the genuinely disadvantaged. Yeah. But like Christian charity. This guy's gotta go. Where are our mods? Our mods are nowhere to be found today. I don't know what's going on. So, some people are naturally unlucky. Yeah. You know, what if you're born, like, without arms or something? That's pretty unlucky. It is important that my child's school instills religious values. Yeah, should be Catholic. Sex outside marriage is usually immoral. It's always immoral. A same-sex couple in a stable, loving relationship should not be excluded from the possibility of child adoption. Disagree. You should not. If you're a homosexual, you should not be adopting children. Homosexuality is really the result of trauma. In most cases, homosexual acts and desires are the result of traumatic experiences in childhood, largely. Or something that has gone awry in socialization and just basically early childhood development. That is why you have high partner counts. That is why you have promiscuity. That is why you have You know, even if you don't see same-sex actions as deviancy, you have deviancy on top of that. You've got drugs, which is involved, and, you know, it's a rebellion against God, just general anti-religiosity among them. So, no, children should not, I'm sorry, but children being in orphanages, frankly, is better than being brought up in a household where they're being instilled with something that is immoral. It's better to grow up in an orphanage and not go to hell than be brought up in a gay household and have your whole orientation warped, not even just your sexual, but your moral orientation warped, and land in hell. Because you're raised by your parents, you love your parents, and if that's all you know, that's scandal. That's called scandal. Scandal is the sin of leading others to sin, and it's the worst sin when it's directed at children. So I'm sorry, but, you know, to project normalcy from a same-sex partnership for a child, that's wrong, and the state should not promote that. Pornography depicting consenting adults should be legal for the adult population. Disagree. Make it illegal. And, you know, the only reason I'm not saying strongly disagree is because I do have some concerns about how that would be regulated, but it shouldn't be illegal. What goes on in a private bedroom between consenting adults is no business of the state. I actually agree about that. The reason why we talk about that is because this essentially is a red herring. This is a completely dishonest argument, typically. The way that this argument is traditionally used is to say, well, if I'm gay, or if I'm a pervert, or if I'm a pedophile, or I'm polyamorous, or I'm into bestiality, well, as long as I do it in my own bedroom. And, well, I mean, pedophilia should be illegal, and bestiality should be illegal, and polyamory should be illegal. And, but if you are strictly talking about what you do in your bedroom, like if you have oral sex with your wife and you're not Christian, like, should the state make that illegal? I don't think so. I think that's overstepping. But the problem is when it's public. I have a problem when it's public, when it's promoted by the state or it's promoted in the public square. So I have a problem with it in advertisements, TV shows, movies, music, billboards, print media, and when it's promoted by the state. But, you know, if you're in your house, I don't, you know, what is the government going to say? Oh, hey, did you eat your wife out? You're going to jail. Do you know what I mean? I mean, that's crude and vulgar. I apologize, but you understand. I don't want, you know, the police to arrest people and people in courts, and they're like, did you or did you not, you know, do certain sexual acts, even in a heterosexual context. I don't think that's right. But the problem is, the reason why people would be like, what, you think that's wrong? Because typically, this is used by homosexuals to say, we just want to do this in the privacy of our own home. And it's like, no, you don't. You want to do it in the fucking parade. And you want to do it on TV. And you want to do it on the streets. And you want to do it in restaurants. And you want to paint rainbow crosswalks and have rainbow flags. And you want it on television and on the Super Bowl. And that's not okay. Now, if you just shut the fuck up about it and I don't know about it and it's in your home, like, well, then to me, it doesn't exist. But, I think that should be social. Social shaming should do away with that, not the state in that case. So I actually agree with that. In its pure and honest form, I agree that a private bedroom, if it's adults, it's not the business of the state. I tend to agree. No one can feel naturally homosexual. Yeah, I'm kind of with Ben Shapiro on this one, in the sense that, I mean, we can feel naturally inclined towards all kinds of sins. I mean, somebody, like, for example, many of you may be naturally inclined. You may naturally want to have sex out of wedlock. Now, that doesn't make it a good thing. That doesn't mean you should act on it. But people do have a natural inclination for it. And you might have an inclination towards bad things, too. You might have a natural inclination towards risk or towards violence. You might have a natural inclination towards murder or stealing, or homosexuality for that matter. So, you know, so I actually agree with Ben's characterization of this question. I don't know if you have a gene that makes you homosexual. I don't know if it's a genetic thing. But I think a person can, you know, involuntarily have those tendencies. I think that's true. That doesn't mean they're okay. These days, openness about sex has gone too far. Yeah, obviously agree. Let's see how we did. Are you ready? Are you ready for the big reveal? I don't like this song, by the way. Let's see, where did I land? Oh, no, 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 what? That's weird. Usually I end up way more authoritarian. Interesting. So I'm kind of near the center. But I'm on the left. I guess left-wing economically, but more authoritarian. So where do I land? Who am I there with? Is there, I'm a centrist. I guess I'm closer to Stalin than I am to Hitler, right? Interesting. Centrist Nick. I told you, I'm a lot more moderate than you would think. Nozbol centrism. Nick the centrist. I'm surprised I ended up on the left. I mean, I guess it makes sense that I'm basically in the center. But I'm a little surprised at that result. What do you think? Is that what you expected? Is that make a lot of sense? It's the sodomy question. I don't think that's it. It's inaccurate, yeah. Well, there you go. Nozbol Nick. Optics Respector says the questions are bad. Yeah, the questions suck. You and Tim Pool can go hang out in that van. Why, did we get the same score? I got the same, says some people. Nick the Nozbol. Yes, expected. If you don't choose strongly agree, disagree, then this happens. I should have been more strongly. The problem is the questions are bad, so I would say strongly agree or strongly disagree, but the questions are too ambiguous for me to say, you know, like one way or another. Wow, so I ended up over here.